Back in Power BI, we continue along with our Learning Power BI by doing the dashboard in a day. The best way to learn Power BI is to get in with a real data set. I'll put the description to the link of the dashboard in a day below, but you can also search for it in your browser. And dashboard in a day is a 3 to 4 hour exercise. In part one, we loaded our data. Today in part two, we're still in lab one. There's 5 labs, and we are going to continue on with lab one, dashboard in a day, and we're going to do some data preparation. We're going to rename some columns. We're going to rename our queries. We're going to show you how to do change data from an example. We're going to do some comma delimiter splitting. So let's get into Power BI. Back in Power BI, and we are continuing along with our Dashboard in a Day 2023. If you have not watched part one, look for that at the link above. You can click the link above or also look on this channel. But Dashboard in a Day is a chance for you to learn Power BI step by step, and we're going through the 2023 edition. In the first step, we loaded the data, we loaded a CSV, we loaded a Excel, and we loaded a third type of source, files from a folder. So now we're gonna continue along part two, and now at this point, we're gonna start doing some of the data preparation. So the first thing we're gonna wanna do, this code at the top is called your M code inside each of these tables. And the steps of those M code are on the right-hand side. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take this transform files and close this folder so that we have the other queries. So we have currently 5 queries: sales, product table, geo, manufacturer, and international sales. So the first one is sales. And if you look at the steps involved in the process, we've got the source, promoted headers, and change type. So the next step is to now start naming the table. So we're going to change product table, and we're going to rename that product. And we're going to rename the geo table to geography. Then we have manufacturer. We're just going to make a quick change and capitalize that. And then we have international sales. And all we're going to do to this one is just add the space between international and sales. So that is renaming tables. And that is going to still keep us at 5. And so now we're going to fill some of the empty values. So if you go to the product table, you'll notice we have, in the category table, we have these nulls. And we have mix for the top one. So what we're going to do is, with the product table, and we are going to select the category column, the next thing we're going to do is, from the transform menu, we want to fill down. So we're going to take that mix, and it's going to fill that all the way down. And you see now in the category, everything has been changed to mix by filling that down. So we're going to stay in the product table. And the next thing we're going to try is splitting columns. Now remember, we're in the Power Query Editor. And we're doing our data preparation. We're getting everything ready so we can start to make some formulas. And then eventually down the road, we are going to do some data visualizations. So what we want to do now is, from the product column, you notice we have these products and they are separated by a couple of different things. They have this bar in the middle that separates the product from the type, which is all season. So if you go to split column and underneath the transform table, we are going to split by the delimiter. So the delimiter that we're going to split by is going to be the pipe symbol. And the pipe symbol is on your keyboard, and that is the pipe symbol. And when we hit OK on that, we are going to split by that pipe. So now we have product 2, which has all season, and we have product 1. So now we're going to rename the columns. So the product 1, we're going to just delete the period dot 1 and name that product. And then for the product 2, we're going to double click and name that segment. So now we have a product table, we have a segment column, and we're still doing all of this in the product. So again, we're preparing the data. And if you notice on the right-hand side, those applied steps get added to the changes on this query. So we're still in the product, we change the type, then we rename the columns. So now we're going to use a feature called Use Column from Examples to change the columns. So we're still going to stay in the product table. And what we're going to do is we are going to go to the price table. And we are first going to add a column. So you've got transform the current column. And then you've got adding columns. So we're going to make sure that our product query is selected. Then we're going to go to the add columns. And then we're going to go to this choose column from examples. And we're going to go from selection. The other option you have is from all columns. So we're going to go from selection. So now we're going to do some columns from examples. So if you type, we have price column selected, and we want to pull out that $412.13. If you noticed, all of the text after that delimiter now pulls that price out. And this is called adding columns from examples. And what we're going to do now is change the name to MSRP. And then we're going to hit OK. So now we've created a new column by adding a column and a column from example, and we've added the MSRP. So right now that's set up as a text column. This ABC is a text. And if you click on that little icon, we can now change that. And we're going to change that to a fixed decimal sum number to reflect dollars. So now that changed to the symbol, dollar symbol, and it's right justified on, and then we've changed the type too. So now we've added a column from example, we've renamed that column, and then we added the change type to add to a fixed decimal. So we're going to create the currency column in the same way. So now the next thing we're going to do, from all columns, we created our first column from example, and we're going to make our second one. And this time around, we're going to select the price category, and we are in the product table, price column, and we're going to do a column from selection. And what we're going to do here is we want to extract the USD into a column. So we're going to go USD, and all of those USDs become its own column. And we're going to name that currency. So we've extracted the column and rename that currency. And the next thing we're going to do is just hit OK. And now we've added two additional columns from that original import of data. So that's how quickly you can transform data, you can add additional information. We're creating these dimension tables so that later on, this is how we're going to filter and analyze some of our data. So we had a price as one column, and now we have the price as MSRP, as a currency, and then we have the actual currency as text. So that is where we're at with adding columns from example. So now that we have that, we can remove this price column because that information is now duplicated into the MSRP and the currency. So what we can do is from the transform column at the beginning, you can right click and we can remove that price column. So now we're going to start removing unwanted rows. We're going to go back to the home table and we're going to go to the geography query. And if you notice, those first two rows at the top contain some null information. So we're going to remove rows, which is in the home column, and we're going to remove top rows. And we are going to remove those top two rows. And when you hit OK, now those null values. But now we have that first column, and that is what we want to actually get to the use first rows as headers. So we want to use the first row as headers, and now that'll bring up our zip, city, state, region, district, and country. So we're starting to transform this data so that we can use it. And the next thing we're going to do for the zip, we want to change this to text again, just like we did the last time. So we want to replace the current step. And the last time we did it in the sales column, this time we're doing it in the geography table. And then the final thing we're going to do with this data preparation is from the manufacturing table, we have some bottom rows that need to be deleted. So we're going to go back to the home table. We're going to remove the bottom rows and we're going to remove the bottom three rows. So we're starting to transform this data and starting to be able to use this. And now we have completed some of the basic data preparation. So that's going to do it for part two. In part one, we loaded the data. And in part two, we transformed the data. Again, I will put the link above and you can look for it in for the following along exercise. I'll put the Dashboard in a Day link in the description below. You can also search for it in your web browser. But again, the best way to use Power BI, your five-step process for Power BI. Number one is to load the data. Then you start to prepare the data. Then you make your measures. And then you start to create your reports and visualizations. And then you finalize that for how you're going to share it, setting up your bookmarks and things like that. It's Dashboard in a Day 2023. This is part two. And hope you're following along in learning Power BI.